Hi everyone, welcome to another Make a Card Monday video. Today I'm totally going to be channeling my inner Laura Bassin because she loves to do this kind of plaid snapping technique that I'm going to show you guys today. And she also loves to use these little memento, little dewdrop ink pads. And I picked up this ink pad set from Simus Stamp. It has 12 different ink colors and they're kind of bright rainbowy colors. So I'm going to go ahead and get started. The first thing I'm going to do is take this die from Simus Stamp. This is from the Talk Bubbles die set. There's three little dies in it. And I'm going to cut out this cloud shape. I'm going to be using some masking paper. I'm going to be using some Nina Desert Storm Environmental cardstock. And I'm going to score this at 5.5. And I'm going to be stamping over the entire front of the cardstock, of the card base. So I'm going to be using this removable label tape. You could actually just use some washi tape, but I like this because it's really, really wide. I can tear it off, has a little some metal teeth there, you can tear it off. It's a little expensive. It's like $17, $18, but you get like 36 yards. This will last me till the end of time. There's so much on here. And I like it because I can then come right over where the score marks are, where I scored the card base. In fact, I'm going to fold this so I can see it just a little better. And put that masking tape down. Right there. And now I know that all of my stamping is not going to go over to the back side of the card. In fact, just because I don't want it to get all over my mat, I'm going to bring in my craft sheet from Ranger. I've had a few people ask about this recently. This is the craft sheet from Ranger. It's actually quite larger than this when you buy it, but I cut it down so that it fits on my work surface really nicely. So like I said before, I'm going to be doing some plaid stamping, and I learned this from Laura Bassin. I've seen her do this actually in person, and it's amazing. She's an excellent precision stamper. So I'll go ahead and leave a link for you guys down in the info bar, or if you're at my blog, there'll be a link there. But she has perfected this technique, so I'm totally going to, like I said before, channel my inner Laura Bassin and try to make some plaid myself. All right, before we get to the stamping, I'm going to take my little mask that I created with that die, peel off the backing, and I'm actually going to put a little sentiment in here eventually, so I'm just going to put that down. Make sure all those edges are down really well. And I'm going to be using this stamp set from Clearly Besotted. This is the Basic Stripes stamp set. And I think I'm going to start with the three right here. And then I can start stamping. I think I'm going to have Lilac Posies be this first one. The extent of my knowledge of Memento inks is using black and brown for Copics. So I'm hoping these stamp really well. And I'm going to take it out of diagonal. It's looking a little splotchy. I'm a little concerned. That's not too bad. All right, now I'm going to switch to another block. I have quite a few different clear blocks, so I'm just going to switch to another one so that I can use a different stamp. All right, and I think I'll do Grape Jelly this time. All right, I have yet another really long block, so I'm going to use that one. And this time I will use Pear Tart. Totally breaking out every single long block that I have. So I'm going to use the very last border stamp. And I think I will use, Dandelion. I'm going to skip the orange color for now because I think this needs yellow. All right, I'm going to have it. It's going to have to overlap where the mask is. I think that's the best way to make it work. The area where it's not going to be long enough. Okay, so I'm going to keep repeating this across, and then I'll get on to when I do the other portion. Okay, so I ended up putting some paper underneath because that absorbs all the ink and that doesn't transfer to the underside of the card, and I forgot about that, but I did catch it before it got too bad. So I'm going to go ahead, since I like to kind of stamp in this direction, I'm going to turn this around, or let's see, like this, so that I can start going in the other direction. And I don't have very much yellow and green, so I'm going to make sure that that I put the pink and purple in the center, put the yellow and green on the sides. So I'm going to start with the pink, I think. I'll just stamp that right across the center. I'm going to have that start on the masked area and then have it continue on. Okay, so there is all of the stamping done. So now it's time to reveal the masking. So there's a little cloud shape, and I'm going to use this Pillow Talk stamp set from Simon Says Stamp. I'm using this one in particular because I want to use this high and then a little heart. And I'm going to use the Rich Cocoa Dewdrop ink pad for this. And then the little heart with Lilac Posies. All right, to finish things off, I'm going to do some details with my white gel pen. I'm going to draw around the outside of the cloud shape. It's going to really define the area. All right, and then I'm going to take a dashed line through the yellow so that it's part of the plaid. And I think I'm also going to take it through in between the pink, just because it needs to have a little bit more white to make it not stand out so much. All right, and I'm going to round these two outer corners with my half inch corner rounder. And that is the card for today. Super simple, really simple concept, but it is a little bit time consuming. Anyway, so I hope this is a kind of a good homage to Lara and her stamping. She is amazing. So anyway, check her out over at her blog, and I will see you guys later. Thanks for watching. I have three videos for you guys to check out today, and it is the first video is from 1 year ago, the second video is from 2 years ago, and the third video is from 3 years ago. So I hope you guys check that out. If you like this video and you want to see more card videos in the future, go ahead and hit that subscribe button in the top corner. And if you want to send this card to a friend or this video to a friend, go ahead and hit that share button down below as well. You can visit my blog at kwarnerdesign.com, and you can follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and Pinterest. As usual, all the supplies I use in this video are listed down below in the video description. So if you have a question about what I've used, go ahead and check out that list. There are direct links to online stores where you can buy those supplies. Thanks for watching, and I will catch you guys on Wednesday for a new video.